Frenchman Gérald Marie was the super agent who decided, or torpedoed, the careers of supermodels. He even married one of the most famous of them all, Linda Evangelista. But our global investigation has uncovered more than a dozen former models with shocking accusations about the 70-year-old. They say he's a predator who ritually abused and raped young women, including minors, in his care. Tonight, they're demanding Gérald Marie be held accountable for his depravity.
Being an agent in the 80s was so spectacular and exciting and glamorous. Money was everywhere, and we made lots of it.
As vice president of Elite Chicago in the 80s, Marie P. Anderson reveled in those heady days. And as part of the elite company, she happily and unwittingly sent American models to Elite's Uber agent, Gérald Marie.
Slowly but surely, I was getting phone calls from Europe from the models complaining about Gérald Marie and telling me stories of either sexual harassment or sexual assault. And they would swear me to secrecy. So I never betrayed their trust.
How many girls did you get calls from?
My memory serves 4 to 5 girls.
Marie P. Anderson, once vice president of Elite Chicago, left the company in disgust in 1990. It was on hearing a heated conversation between two female executives, Gérald Marie and the founder of Elite, John Casablancas. The women were trying to protect the youngest of their models.
I'm now hearing the women begging the men to stop sleeping with the 13 and 14-year-olds. And Gérald, with his Paris accent, says, girls, we are men, we have our needs. And John's response was, come on, stop being so puritanical. It's no big deal. And I was so stunned listening to that conversation, I had to get up and leave. And I quit Elite because I didn't want to be part of that organization. If this is the culture that I have to work within inside of an agency, I don't want to be part of an agency. So I quit the business. Boom. It is my hope that Gérald would experience what any predator should experience, and that is prosecution and incarceration.